Omari Hardwick playing Ghost, James Ghost St. Patrick. This is 50.com. I'm glad y'all are here. Peace.
That's ordinary, this excellence. When I fuck up, I correct shit like security. Come get this bitch, my nigga. I said, come get this bitch. Nigga trying to shine with my diamond shining. They say the grind, no, never mind.
This is 50. We're still here on the set of Power. I'm here with Omari Hardwick, the lead in this, in Power.
Yes, isn't that amazing that 50 actually, he hired me?
I know, right? He's kind of cool. I don't know. He has this thing where he like hires awesome people.
He's great at that.
Get on safe, Lakeisha.
Thank you. Everything okay?
Yeah. You good? Entertaining our guests?
It's late, baby. Why don't we go home? You know, we could do a little celebrating of our own. How is it working with him?
It's been really good, man. Because, you know, he's like 8 years old inside this grown man.
He's like a little kid.
You know, so brilliant, smart, savvy, you know, creative. It's been really nice to just sort of have a brother away from the colleague and the boss. It's just been nice to find this brother. So today, I was supposed to be presenting him with this incredible painting where I have him as an 8 year old painted, and then me as an 8 year old painted.
Oh, that's
next
awesome.
To each other. Crazy, beautiful painting, animal ambition and graffiti on a brick wall, the whole thing. So today was supposed to be the presentation of it.
Oh, that's, did you paint this yourself?
No,
oh, okay, okay.
No, I commissioned the cat, he did it up and the whole nine, but we didn't get it here on time, you know, black people.
Well, CPT. But well, I'm pretty sure we will see that in the G-Unit office.
Yes, the world is,
yeah, I would love to see that.
It's going to be, you know, I'm proud of it.
But you were just gone. And then when my pops died, I thought then at least you would reach out.
Well, tell us a little bit about your character, Ghost, and Power.
Ghost is... In a nutshell, he is, you know, and it's such a great question to ask in the beginning of the season when I'm not yet living Ghost.
Yes.
And it's equally as cool to ask it when I'm fully.
Because it's almost like a double life,
yeah,
a double
at this
character.
Point, yeah. You're interviewing me at a point where I'm living with this guy. He is definitely more crazy than I thought when I started, you know, if that makes sense. He's this duplicitous, dichotomous, really complex guy who comes from the illegal push or selling of narcotics and makes a whole bunch of money and is able to afford the lavish things in life. And then he, you know, flips it and kind of is trying to prove to the world, his wife included, and when I say the world, that he can graduate and go to this other place in life where he can own clubs and name them Truth. The irony behind that, of course,
is that his life is a lie.
It's a lie. And so he's brilliant at it. He's brilliant at going into different environments, you know. And if he's at the White House, he would speak, you know, that jargon or that vernacular. If he's in the hood, he would speak that. So he's this guy, but he's a father at the end of the day. You know, we haven't talked about that enough interviews, but he is a father and a husband and is having an affair with life. I wouldn't even say with the individual. He's having an affair with life and trying to figure out how to get in where he fits in.
When we met, what'd you think I was gonna be? Hmm?
The biggest goddamn drug dealer in New York City.
Do you think that your character is gonna be like a positive? It's like a positive thing or like a negative thing?
That's a good question. I think.
Thank you.
I think a positive in the sense that. Especially as brown and black people, we tend to like live in a very marginal view of life. From travel, you know, we'll spend money on some
Jordans.
Red bottoms or Jordans and then, you know, complain that we don't have enough money to buy a plane ticket, which there was two plane tickets. And, you know, and so we don't think outside of that box. And I think where 50 and I really jive, ironically, is, you know, to answer your question, is that we think of it in a way of, we'll take the positives of this guy that on paper, particularly by others in life that might judge this guy, on paper he would be thought of as a negative character.
Really?
Yeah, because there's the drugs. Yeah. And once you're guilty by association, so, you know, Omari Hardwick's playing a drug dealer.
Yeah.
They don't see everything else that I'm playing.
That he's a father and a husband.
Yeah,
and
a dreamer. You know, just a dreamer. Everybody deserves a shot. So I think the positive side of it will be seen because I'm playing it. So I got to be confident that my skill level as an actor is going to be enough that, you know, you can find some positive. If you're a 13-year-old kid watching at home, or if you're the 75-year-old ex-drug dealer, who used to know that life, you know, who's married or not married now. So
are there any parts of your character that you say sometimes are you, like?
Yeah, I would say that I don't think, you know, that an actor can ever truly play a character if there's not enough adjectives in describing the character that the actor doesn't also possess.
Yes.
I don't need all the adjectives. You know, I don't have to fully be Ghost, but I got to at least be 60% of this guy.
60%.
At least 60. That's a great way to end it.
Well, thank you so much.
And there it was.
Why the fuck would you come around here? I can hear your heartbeat. Yeah, you know a dog sense fear. I can hear your heartbeat. You bark while we bite around here. I can hear your heartbeat.